Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here with the game. It's going to be Jing Bang with Zach, gaming. No time being wasted, as it's going to be Jing Bang. We're in the ninth round, starting on the CD side. Nato, the only man with the kit, while the rest of his teammates are just going to be sticking with the Kevlar and USP. So, trying to be very... They seem to be very confident in their aim. Blood filler. Blood filler, I'm sorry. Getting boosted up over near mains. As Falcon is lurking right behind the squeaky door. He's got the Tech 9 armor. So I'm going to be playing the raid boss. Well, the rest of his teammates are going to burst out into mid. I'm trying to go for this A split. Two guys coming out from mid. Boosted over. While one guy over at B. And they're going to be going for the B fake instead. Actually, C4 is making his way over to the A bomb site. Bloodfeller is still holding the A bomb site here. Spawn is making a lot of noise over in B. And Pyro has actually pushed into the B bomb site. While Pasha is taking a duel here. He's taking a lot of damage. He's finally get NK, but not to over in the site. And Bloodfeller, I think, he has an inkling here. He's actually waiting at Assbuster, meanwhile holding over the B bomb site. And here to come charging into the A bomb site. Here the other two guys left alive for the team, for the T's and Leo Adrian. Last one left alive in a 1v5. It's going to be almost impossible for him, as he is going to get taken down by Nato with a Tech 9. And Bloodfeller surviving one point of health. And it's going to be a pretty impressive hold there. Jingbang not falling for any of the accuracy's shenanigans, not falling for the fake, the B fake there. It looked a little convincing, but. Discipline being shown by Jingbang, with Nato staying put inside the B, inside the A bomb site. So, aggressive gaming, lots of effort from them trying to fake that up, but not working out. Now, we have a force buy coming out from the T's. Nades raining in from the CT's. Leo Adrian, he should be careful. He's going to come charging out through the smoke. Might have got spotted out by the guy over near highway. Nato's playing up close with his teammates as well. So, the three guys pretty much over in the A bomb site. Smoke up. Jumping and spotting. He spots one guy out. He doesn't know there's one guy over in Cubby. This could be dangerous for him. And it's still very cheeky. He's going to miss the guy, and this could be massive. The polio Adrian, just up close, smoker. Little too careless there. He hadn't spotted out the guy over in Cubby. And now it's going to be Bloodfiller. And Nato do something. And Power is going to take down Nato. Bloodfiller going huge with MP7, picks up three quick kills, gets the fourth as well, and Skull give it down to Spawn. And who is going to be able to take down Bloodfiller? He's got a deagle, but bomb is dropped over in highway where they have one of the CTs covering it. That's going to be Assbuster with the MP9. That's a beautiful name. He'll be looking to bust some masses. Meanwhile, Spawn, he's got still 40 seconds to work with, so time isn't quite his enemy yet. Smoke from him to block off vision from the CT over at truck. Meanwhile, slowly creeping up here into highway. He should notice one of the CTs waiting there. Spots a man out. With a guy in Z as well who has spotted out spawns. This should be almost impossible for him to clutch. 17 points of health is all he has remaining. 1 point of health. And at this juncture, he's just trying to hold on to his gun here. Don't die after the timer runs out. Aspas is going to take him down. It's going to be a great quad kill from Bloodfiller there. Doing huge work. Because at that point, I think it was a 3v5, if I'm not mistaken. In favor of accuracy gaming. Working out quite well for that Bloodfiller. Like I said, doing great work with the MP7. Picks up two, gets a third there, and finally gets a fourth as well. And bear in mind, they weren't a full buy. A force buy, Tech 9 armor, and they didn't get the bomb down to accuracy gaming. So, two rounds with no bomb down is gonna ensure that they won't be able to go for any... Well, they'll be able to buy the next round, obviously, but it won't be that comfortable. They weren't able to go for a complete full buy. Spawn, just a few Peter 50s, just one Peter 50 in fact, and it's gonna be the Glock train coming into the B bomb site, and they could just get shredded to pieces. Like the Watergate scandal papers getting put through the shredder. And Assbuster, he hears them coming to check us. As Pasha is gonna find one. Assbuster still spraying around. And they're going to pick up double kills. Both of them picking up two kills apiece. Spawn, last one left alive over in mid. It should be a comfortable kill here for the CTs over in mid. There we go. Bloodfiller is going to take him down with the SMG, with the P90. 3-0 to Jingbang. Accuracy will be able to buy up. They are going to get the AWP as well onto Spawn. AK-47s on the rest of the members. And, a pretty decent amount of utility as well. They do have Four smokes. Forkin will just have to make do with the AK and the armor. No resources for him whatsoever. And spawn with the op. He's going to spawn a man on a great shot at the Nato. Nato wouldn't be expecting that. Getting him right before the smoke bloomed. Now we do have a guy who's playing it very aggressively here over at mid. That is Smoker. But he's not going to push into the smoke. And spawn just rattling off a few shots. And NK, I think, has an inkling. I think he knows. And Nate's going to come in. And that's going to be pretty nasty team Nate there. And smoke up, spar it out, but he's going to get the kill onto NK, tying things up 4-4. And I still know he's there. Let's try to get out of this cubby. The smoke's still there, so we can get out of there if he did wish to. I think he's planning to play a little bit more aggressively. Molotov to get tossed inside the B mains. Sorry, over at mid. That's the rest of the T's. We have Spawn and Leo. They're slowly making their way here. Leo leading the way. He's going to spot a man over in headshot. Tapping away. He's not going to get the kill. Finally gets Pasha. But there's still a man inside the side. And he's going to get caught up with his pants down there. Aspas are taking a little bit of while to take him down. But it's a 3v3. And Smoker over in mid could go in for the very fast rotate if required. They still have a guy over in the A-bomb. Such as Aspas. So he's going to come up big here. He spots a man up there. Gets a kill on the Falcon. And they're just getting picked apart one by one by Assbusters. So this is a little sloppy from accuracy. And Assbuster just staying alive, doing a ton of damage, catches out spawn as well, and that's one danger man taken out of the equation. It's on a triple kill as well, and it's all on a pyro. And the flashbang is going to come in from him to help his teammate out, who has made his way over to Vend. That is Smoker, and that's going to be all on the pyro now in a 1v3, and should be an impossible task for him. And he is going to get taken out. A quad kill from Assbuster. That's going to be 4-0 for Jing Jang. I love that name. Buster, early aggression over in B mains. He's just going to hold behind the smokes. It's going to be pretty much a full buy, pretty much a half-assed buy coming out from accuracy here. Some Tech 9s, a couple of P250s. Bear in mind, they still haven't got the bomb down yet, and it's going to be the fifth round. They're going to come pouring into the A bomb site where they have Nato to contend with, and it's going to be blood flow with a P90, just spraying everyone down. It's going to get, actually just going to get two kills. Nato's going to pick up a double kill, and it's going to be Leo Adrian alone here, and Nato. Comes up from quads, picks up a triple kill, and that's going to be another comfortable round for Jing Bang, just losing the P90, and the money is looking very, very solid and very comfortable indeed for Pasha, Bloodfiller, Smoker, Nato, and Assbuster. See here, smart play from Nato. Second, he knows going to be a push coming in, he just holds inside his sight, helps his teammate out. Nice shot, nice kill in the second one guy there on Falcon. Fire out coming out from accuracy. They do have multiple AKs brought out. No ops this time around. NK is going to spot a guy over in sandbags. And he's going to try and nade him down. And Smoker should be taken down. He's down to 4 points of health. How is he still alive? And it's such a dangerous spot because even with 4 points of health, he has the advantage. Fine is going to get taken over Leo Adrian. Just running and gunning on top. A spawn is going to find Nato. It's going to be a two-man advantage here. Bloodfiller boosted on top of the white boxes. He spots a man over in highway, and he has been spotted out now, though. Going to drop down, shift his position up. He's still going to get the kill on the pyro, and spawn not playing very, very safe. They could have gone for the refrag immediately. Instead, it's going to be his other teammate is going to get it. And Pasha missing a lot of easy shots and going to hit a little tougher one. It's now a 2v3, and he's going to decide to get the hell out of there, or maybe not. He's going to swap all the way to the AK. So they might be just be going for this. 3v2, pretty much doable here. As Assbuster is making his way quietly over from mains. If he just waited for that flashback from his teammates, it would be perfect. Molotov's going to come in. He's been spotted out, though. And they're going to push him out. Pasha's going to find Falcon, the nade to come in. And that could do a ton of damage. Pasha's going to find another man as well. God, going to pick up triple kill, but spawn is going to fall. And Assbuster is going to get the kill in the end there. And it's going to be quite impressive retake from Jingbang. 2v4. And yet they managed to pull it off, especially Pasha. With the op kill, followed by two AK kills there. So great play from Jingbang, and they're not going to allow accuracy to still get any round on board. Max money bonus coming in. They did get the bomb down, so they will be able to get the a pretty decent buy as well. As They do have two guys boosted real quickly. Yes, Smoker. Gonna do the smart thing. Just flash his way back and gonna fall over near the E-box there. He's gonna be seeing a lot of action really soon. Spawn with a great opening kill on Blood Filler. Smoker not at the hole for the spot a guy over in Highway. And Nato is holding the tight angle. Smoker is completely blinded. Then he's gonna get taken down. Caught out looking the wrong way as his pincer play coming up from the T's, and Nato still inside his sight. A perfect time peek out. There's gonna find one. Continues his spray. Not able to get the kill though. He's gonna get swarmed from behind. As Nato does pick up a double kill, however. There's gonna be now again to Pasha and Assbuster once more to go for the retake. Pasha with the M4A1. And this time it's gonna be coming in here from A mains. And Assbuster, he spots a flashbang coming up. And now they know there's a guy over inside of A mains. And K with a great kill onto Assbuster. It's all down to Pasha in a 1v3. You just know one member is. But this is going to be almost an impossible task. A perfect crossfire being set up. A spawn is going to take down Pasha. That's going to be the first round on board for Accuracy Gaming here. And they will still be able to buy up. Jing Bang. And for Accuracy, now is the time for them. If they're able to string. If they're able to string two rounds, if they're able to get one more round here, they could potentially force Jing Bang on a very hard force buy. Well, not a completely hard force buy, but, you know, a 4C buy. And that to get at least 3-4 rounds on board. Excuse me, I'm burping a lot. And a very fast play coming up from Accuracy Gaming. This could actually catch out Jing Bang by surprise here. But they haven't checked quads yet. That is crucial mistake there. Bluffler is going to find one. He's going to stay alive. Not down 50 points of health, though. But he might be able to reload in time. Yes, he will. NK's going to find Smoker in the meantime. He peeks around the corner, though. Just running in. He's going to take a number Falcon, leaving it all on Assbuster in a 1v4. And this should be impossible. Accuracy Gaming changing things up a little bit. Just pushing in over to the A bomb side real quickly. But like I said, they should have had at least one guy marking quads. And the Blood Filler wouldn't have been able to get even that one kill hit it managed to get there. As it's gaming, they make it 6-2. And like I said, the money is going to be a little tough here. Oh, the money's going to be pretty horrendous. Pretty horrendous right now. Second round they're losing here. It's going to be pretty much reset. They're going to get $1,900. And the majority of the players will be in, you know, less than $4,000. Two of the 1,000. And only Assbuster will have money to go for a buy. So, yeah, they do have the money to go for a very iffy buy. You know, maybe an M4 in the mix. Another M4 in the mix. A FAMAS coming out. Maybe Swag 7, whatever. But like I said, yeah, money's not that great here. And they just might force it up. They're going to play the safe route here. They're going to rely on Asperger's M4A4, while the rest of them are just going to upgrade the pistols. CZs, P250s coming out. Three P250s, one CZ, and the one flashbang at Pasha. And Asperger's up with full utilities and the kit as well. He does have the extra money to go for that. And that's a smart buy from Jingman. They really don't need to make haste here. It's up 6-2. We still have the advantage here. But Spawn gonna open things up, takes on Nato. Will they be expecting another man hiding? And it's gonna be NK spots out Smoker's head there and is gonna kiss him goodnight. That's gonna leave it all down to last three men left alive. Leo Adrian dropping in from above. Takes on Pasha pretty comfortably, leaving it down now to Assbuster and Blood. They know Assbuster's still lurking around there with the M4. And they would be trying to get that gun away from his hands. He's playing it very safe over in Squeaky, already going for the save as NK is going to find Blood Filler. Now a 1v5, as Assbuster would be looking to hold on to his rifle, but the rest of the T's, they are looking, going for the hunt here. And they have the time as well. Bomb just getting planted a few seconds. And they're taking this very methodically. They don't want to give away too many weapons. It's Pyro. It's coming in. Flanking in here. And Assbuster just holding the tight angle. Pyro checks the spot. He spots that Assbuster. Doesn't have to go for the fight. Gets one from behind. But it's so low in health here and gets scissored by Pyro and NK coming in from Squeaky. And he will not be able to save that gun. Jing Bang will be able to buy it pretty decently though. No ops perhaps. Just M4s all around. And Accuracy Gaming as well. Just going to stick with the AKs. And the money's looking pretty solid right now. Falcon, $1,000. NK and $6,700. Rest of them, an average about $4,000. So pretty decent money right now. As Jing Bang will buy up. They do have 5 M4s. Not much when it comes to resources. They're going to use all the smokes early on and the Molotovs as well. They just have flashbangs and one smoke remaining on Pasha. And Pasha, he's over from mid. Well, Smoker's pushed it pretty aggressively over in mid here. Smoke wall coming out from the T's. Smoker should be careful. A spawn is going to get boosted up. But he's going to fall back. Because the three guys playing mid for the CT, so they're not going to give up. Mid fact is, Smoker pushing it so deep is going to give them all the information. So it's kind of two ways that smokes for the T's, because now the CT's know, hey, they might be smoking off mid, but they haven't made any play. It's just, you know, just trying to confuse them. And smoke over and vent is going to be very helpful, as they will be going for the retake here real quickly. Rotation rather, because the bomb's not, still not planted. Nice counter flash is coming to get the first kill of the NK. Assbuster in the sight. He's going to show himself finally. He has a spot route. Smoker is going to get the kill. Assbuster finds one. He's going to find it taken down by Forkin. Posh is going to find Forkin. It's all down to Pyra now. And there's a flames right behind him as well. And he's got the bomb though. He might be able to get the bomb down as a retake. He's going to be coming in from Bloodfiller, Smoker, and Nato. Pyro going to get the bomb down. It's coming in from vents, and Jingbang playing it very smart. They're going to be going for the retake all together, all at once. But we're not going to give him those 1v1s. Pyro holding a very standard angle. Spots the first man out. He's going to get Floodfiller. Not going to get a second kill. It's Nato is going to take him down from below. 6-7-4 to Jingbang, as they will be able to halt that small that Accuracy Gaming had. But Accuracy Gaming will be able to buy it pretty comfortably once more. Buster, top fragging for his team in 11. And slightly suspect read coming out from Pasha, going from the MP9. Because Accuracy, if you did your math, would obviously be able to go for the buy here. And there might be a misbuy from Pasha, thinking perhaps that they might be facing off against fully ecoing or a half by Accuracy. Instead, completely bought up. They have a lot of utilities as well, and they got the AWP on spawn. A very dangerous person to give the AWP to. He is getting, trying to get spammed through the door here by the guy over in short and spawn with the AWP. If Smoker's not careful, he can get picked off here. He's gonna come up and show himself quite yet. Spawn might just spot a sliver. Yep, oh, he just missed it. You just see the a little bit of Smoker's body. Yeah, now he has routed off a shot. It's going to do a ton of damage. Nate's going to come in, and it's going to dunk Smoker. And Smoker gets taken down. Without Spawn having to do much, he doesn't take any damage also. So no trades coming in yet. The rest of the T's, they are making their way over to the A bomb site. Bloodfill is going to find one. And NK is going to take down Pasha. Spawn peeks around the corner and takes a Nato. It's still a man inside the side. It's going to be Bloodfiller. He's going to get a second kill. Finally, Spawn takes that up close and personal with the AWP. And it's all on Assbuster now in a 1v3. And it's hard for him. And bear in mind, the money for the CTs are just going to get reset here. It's a great play from Accuracy Gaming. Because Jing Jang not going to have any money to go for any buy whatsoever next round. Most of them just going to be less than $2,000. That's going to be quite painful indeed. Assbuster though, he doesn't have a kit either. Could perhaps pick it off one of his fallen teammates. I think one of them had the had a kit drop in the side. But look at the flank coming in from mid. And NK is going to take down Assbuster pretty comfortably there. 7-4 as Jingbang will, in all probability, go for a full eco here. That nade was just so perfect. As Assbuster going a little aggressive here. It's eco round, but they're just going to get completely decimated. NK with a triple kill. The eco bash and blood filler. Left alone with a CZ. He's going to spot out Spawn. And Spawn is going to go for the fight here. Yes, he is. Drops down and takes out blood filler. No problem whatsoever. They didn't lose a single man that round. So a great round for Accuracy Gaming. They're going to retain all the guns. And they're building up a pretty decent amount of money here as we are in the closing stages of the first half. Jingbang will have to go for a double eco. That's what I say, right? Like, when you lose a number of rounds in a row and then finally get a buy round and you manage to win that round on the CT side especially, and if you lose it and your money gets screwed so hard, you have to go for a double eco, especially so late here, as NK is going to find. But Pasha picks up a great double kill with a P250. Finally is going to get taken on by Pyro, as the T's do have control of the site. And now we do have the rotation coming in from the CTs, but I don't think they'll be in time. Spawn is going to pick off Nato, and Leo Adrian is going to get the bomb down. The last remaining CTs, they do have the 5-7 Bloodfiller. Bloodfiller is an old 1.6 player. Bloodfiller is going to get taken down. He's the guy who had the kit and the CZ. If it got that kill over and guy inside, it could. There was probably slight chance. Smoker playing near the smoke. And here's one of the T's running around below him. He's not going to show himself yet. He knows there's a kit dropped over near generator, so if the T keys aren't careful. He's gonna find kill, but yeah, Pyro's waiting for them. Accuracy are not gonna fall for any ninja attempts as they make it 7-6. And the game is indeed getting very tight. Jingbang will be able to buy up as we are in the penultimate round of the first half. And they're investing a lot in this. We do have the Dak Dak, aka the auto sniper and blood filler, who doesn't have anything else. Just a smoke, no armor. He's going naked here, guys. He's going to contend with spawn with the AWP. He's blinded, rattles off a shot. Not going to find anyone. Assbuster playing aggressively. Right next to the smoke. He's got his teammate as well. Bloodfill has got to be careful here. He's going to take out the auto sniper, but the aim punch comes in. Pyro is just wrecking everyone with the A-bomb. So Liu Adrian is going to take the Bloodfiller. And it's down to Pasha and Assbuster. Some Hawks hold on to these two rifles. And that massive investment not working out. And especially the Dak Dak, I mean the auto sniper. I suppose one of my Australian friends keeps calling it a Dak Dak. That's what they call it in Australia. And I just kind of, I don't know, I like that name, Dak Dak sound. But yeah, the auto sniper, especially at that range with no armor, is going to be very, very painful. As Pasha is going to find one. But he's going to get taken and get hunted out here. But a great shot onto Pyro. But Leo is going to find Assbuster, and Leo might be able to get both the men. That's going to be Assbuster and Pasha taken down, and their money shambles here. They might just be able to buy some FAMASes. Maybe a Maxim in the mix, maybe a Scout. I don't know, but it's going to be a very iffy buy. We do have the CZ coming out of Nato, who's going to opt to go with the CZ and the utility and the armor. Smoker with the armor and Scout. Bloodfiller with the CZ, and Assbuster with the 5.7. So, three upgraded pistols for Mars and a Scout against Accuracy Gaming's four AKs op and all those Molotovs and smokes and utility. And Accuracy Gaming should know this. Assbuster pushing in B very aggressively, but it's a guy marking him. He's holding the angle over in mid. That's bomb. They should be careful here. He should be careful. Just peeking out mid. And Nato with a great shot through the smoke. Takes on Leo Adrian. Bloodfiller holding Zangi, he's been amazing so far, but NK is going to take him down. Nato is going to get another one. Yes, he will. Aspasa comes in with the AK picked off of the fallen T. He's going to get another one here. Nato going to finally fall, and it's down to Forkin and Pyro do something. Make it all alone, and Pyro is going to find one. And he's going to find two more. It's going to be Aspasa and Smoker, and he knows there's a guy over at mains here. And that is, of course, Aspasa with the AK-47. He's going to spot another man out of Smoker with a Scout. Peeks around the corner and gets the kill, and that's going to be the round for Jingbang winning a round, which they honestly had no right winning. That was a very, very shabby buy. And Accuracy Gaming, perhaps getting a little bit themselves, a little too overconfident. They knew that Jingbang had to be on a very, very crappy buy. And we do have a disconnection coming in for Jingbang as we wait for him to come back. Yep. So, 7-8. Accuracy should be pretty happy with that. One thing I've noticed with most of Indian teams are on cash, especially unlike in the international scene. The meta right now is cash is more T-sided, slightly more T-sided, isn't it? But slightly more T-sided. You know, teams tend to win more rounds on the T-side rather than the CD side. But in India, I've noticed most of the teams are still very more strong on the CD side, but the T-side executes leave a lot to be desired. And for Accuracy, if their CD side is anything like how we saw earlier this week against, this week or last week, I forget, I think it was last weekend, against KFP, if their CD side was anything like that, Jingbang's going to have a pretty rough time against these guys. Because Accuracy, they're on point right. Kind of a rough day. But then he's got his counterpart in Smoker, who's on just 5 kills as well, Forkin and 4. But for the rest of his teammates, they are, look at that, 13, 12, 10, 13, 12, 11, and 10. A sequential number of frags for Spawn, NK, Pyro, and Leo, Adrian. And for Jingbang, we do have Assbuster, Pasha, the two guys who have been to pick of the lot, Nato as well, but some great hold over in the A-bomb site. So, pretty tight affair right now. So we don't have I don't know, no word yet from the admin if the players have joined in. So we're just going to cut to a very quick break, listener. When we're back, we'll be resuming with the second half of what's been so far a pretty keenly contested game. And that didn't take long. So we do have Bloodfellow connecting back, as it's going to be interesting play from... it's pretty standard play from Jing Bang. They got four guys in Glock and armor, Nato with the smoke and a couple of flashes. And Nato is over at mid. He hasn't used it yet. Meanwhile, Assbuster holding the angle, but Spawn is going to open things up, peeking into mains, and he's going to take down a man. Forkin's going to find Nato as well, and this is kind of a horrendous start indeed, because the utility is no longer there. They might have picked up one smoke, the smoke, but Pyro is going to take down Pasha, and it's just falling apart here for the T's. And Smoker and Assbuster lost two men left alive. Pyro holding the angle. I think he hears a guy. Smoker's going to find NK. But Forkin is there to go for the immediate trade. Assbuster, last man left alive in a 1v4. He's got the Glock and the C4. And he's gonna rattle off a shot towards Vent. And he's gonna get peeked out over in mid. Takes the fight here. Damn, but it's gonna be Forkin who picks up the triple kill, in fact. Some great shots coming out from Forkin. So he's been having a very quiet game, but waking up in the second half, as Accuracy Gaming are gonna tie things up 8-8. And Jing Bang will force it up. No surprises there. Tech 9 armor. Opting to go with the Deagle, and Assbuster on the P250. He has a flashbang, and they are heading over to the A bomb side real quickly here, where they have to contend with Spawn and Leo Adrian. Leo playing over near highway. Spawn's got the MP7, and that's gonna be a little tricky weapon, especially if like three or four face them. And Spawn is shifting his position up. This could be very risky, especially up close against the Tech 9s and those P250s. He's got a smoke, gonna re-smoke off mains. And he's got his teammate on top as well, on the railings, is it Leo Adrian. I wonder why he calls himself Leo Adrian. Like, people call themselves Adrian or Leo, but Leo Adrian. It's one of the small mysteries of an Counter-Strike. Pasha's gonna spot a Spawn, takes him down without taking any damage whatsoever. Leo Adrian sprays a man down, he's doing a little bit of damage. Oh, Falcon should be careful, as Butler's gonna find Leo. And that's V3. As Nato's pretty down though, but NK, Falcon, and Pyro, we gotta go for this retake. Pyro spots a man over in Forklift. It's gonna be Smoker, just floating with danger there. Pyro waiting for his teammate to flank in from over from mains, and it's gonna be NK announcing himself here. He's gonna spot out the main over near down. Bloodfiller is gonna get the kill. They're so very low though, as Falcon is gonna find one. Pyro finds another man. It's a 2v2 here. Both the guys inside the side. Bloodfiller is going to find the... Actually, Nato gets a kill. He's going to get taken down. It's all on a Falcon now against Bloodfiller. Just got a USP remaining. And Bloodfiller with the Tech 9 up close and personal. Wins the round for Jing Bang. And Accuracy Gaming get taken down there. And I really feel... Look, everything seems fine on hindsight. But Spawn going up and playing that angle, especially when they should have known Jing Bang would be on a forced buy, because they didn't get the bomb down the first round. So if you get the bomb down the first round, you can reasonably believe that the T's would go for a full eco, because you can go for an early buy on a third round. But the fact is, they did not get the bomb down, so they forced it up. And Spawn playing that very aggressive position there, just with a MP7, with no one to set up a no one to set up a very close crossfire with. Yes, he had Leo on top, but Leo, like I said, wasn't able to trade immediately. Just got the one kill before he got taken down, right? So I feel that was kind of a misplay from Spawn, shifting his position there from the side, you know, use the angles, but once he was there, he was pretty much caught out. He had no room to work with, and it's going to be pretty much an A stack coming out from the CTs, while the rest of the T's are going to make the way with the B bomb site. A few upgraded pistols, so Deagle with Falcon. Just one more P250. Smoker's going to catch out a man there, Galil, and going to miss almost all his shots. NK's down 43 points of health, however, and they know where Smoker is, but the rest of the T's are in the B bomb site. Smoker spots the man crossing over. Bloodfiller's going to find Spawn. And Accuracy Gaming looking for some exits here. Smoker finally going to take down NK. They're trying to hunt him down here. And Leo Adrian's going to find Smoker. They might be able to salvage his Galil. And that's more than they would have been hoping for. Pyro is dancing with death, as Pasha is going to take him down, leaving it down to Leo Adrian. He's trying to be cheeky. He's going to open the squeaky door. And they might fall for this. And that's a very smart play from Leo Adrian. Brains, bro. Smart man. This is so smart from Leo Adrian. last second thinking. He knew like he would be get he would get hunted. Just shifting it up a little bit and managing to salvage it a little. Still pretty much an eco run coming from Accuracy Gaming. They do have a couple of upgraded pistols, Forkin and Pyro with the armor. I don't know why Pyro would go with the USP just with the Kevlar. I think that's kind of a waste, because you know that armor is going to help prevent any punch, but USP, you know, against fully armored terror is going to be very tough indeed. Pasha with a very smart buy. He's got the MAC-10. He knows the rest of the CT should be an eco. They're inching the way into A bomb site here. Slowly and steadily, the smoke's going to be raining in now. Flash is coming out. Leo's going to spot the first man out. He's completely blinded though. Crouch is down. He's going to peek out again. Izzy. But he's got Aspaster very close. Going to drop. Aspaster going to get the first kill. And Leo Adrian not able to pull off anything with the Galil itself the previous round. And it's going to be complete massacre in the A bomb site. And Aspaster, if he gets his kill, it's going to be a teammate for his team. It's 10-8. And they did not lose a single man there. Spawn. Trying to perhaps get an exit, but they know where he is. I think they know exactly where he is. They're going to come in here. Is he going to get one? No, he's not. Aspas is going to get the kill for himself. And sorry, that wasn't a teammate. I think Smoke had to get the kill there. So, very comfortable. Very, very comfortable anti-eco run coming up from Jing Bang. And now they are firmly in the lead by 3 rounds in Accuracy Gaming. Byron will come out. They do have the AWP, the AWP on spawn. All the rest of the guys are going to be with the M4. Just 2 kits on Pyro and spawn. Let's see what they're going to try here. As Assbuster is holding the sunroom. Oh, and Smoker with a great shot. And that is one really important member of Accuracy has been taken down. Now that's the AWP taken out of the equation as well. Now Leo Adrian over in Forklift. He has his Forkin as well. But this is a great start for Jing Bang. Leo Adrian shifting it up a little bit. His teammate over in quads as well. The T's are taking it slow here. We have Aspasa trying to fake out a response. He's going to fall back, and there's a guy holding right below Vents. He should have heard that, and they should actually be bringing back the rotation over to the A-bomb site. Yep, they are coming in, but they might be a little bit too late as the T's are going to force their way in, but nice counter flash is coming in from the CTs as well. Leo Adrian still also going to come into inside of MBK. Leo Adrian with a great kill on the Pasha. That's going to make it a 4v4. Molly's reigning in. Forkin is going to get pushed out there, but he's going to toss the flashbang, and that's not going to do much. Much though, Leo Adrian's gonna get the one kill here, and Forkin at 6 points of fell is still gonna get the kill. NK is gonna catch out Aspaster. It's gonna be all down to Bloodfiller in a 1v3. He's gonna find 2. Can he get a third? I think he might have heard NK running. Well, that Bloodfiller with a 1v3 clutch, 28 points of fell in the end, and he still managed to get the kill, running and getting the tech 9. And Accuracy Gaming are gonna be really, really, really annoyed with themselves that round. They had that round 3-1, and he pulls it off. Around spawn trying to be aggressive, but Jing Bang playing very passively. Bloodfiller from top of red box, the mid red box, gonna get the kill. NK spots him out, doesn't take the shot though, and it's not gonna bother trying to fight here. Oh, maybe he is. He's doing a little bit of damage, but he's taking a ton of damage himself. Assbuster just dancing around with NK. He's got the MAC 10, so yeah, he can feel suicidal as he wants. He's gonna fall back though, not gonna give any free guns. Pasha, meanwhile, behind. And he's got two of his teammates making their way over from main as well. Smoker and Nato. Bloodfiller coming in from Squeaky as well. As they're going to be going for it for the four-pronged attack from the two split from Squeaky as well as from main's Pasha. Smokes and the flashes. Forkin still holding inside a forklift with a 5-7 of his. New Adrian's got a 5-7 as well. They're still playing it very passively. Pyro's going to get the kill on Assbuster, finally taken down, but there's just a Uzi as they're actually going to be falling for this. Hook, land, and sinker pretty much. Bloodfiller's going to take the Pyro, and they will be able to get the bomb down here. Smoker running and going to find NK, and the bomb is going to get planted. Meanwhile, Pasha lurking there is going to get both the kills under Leo and Forkin. And Jing Bang not taking any chances whatsoever. And I like that play I like that play, respecting the opponents, knowing, hey, you might be in an eco, doesn't mean you're just going to run in, you know, run and gun and force our way in. We're going to take it slow. We're going to fake you out. We're not going to give you any hint of a chance. Around, and the money's looking very robust indeed for Jing Bang as well. So even if you lose a couple of rounds now, even if accuracy make it to 10 or 11 rounds, Jing Bang will be able to buy it pretty comfortably. Nice buster. Take a little bit of damage from the nade. We got spawn with the AWP as well, and he's playing alone, but he won't be facing any contention from the T's. They are, this A side's been looking very, very susceptible for accuracy gaming, and Jing Bang, they smell it, they know it. They know that accuracy are having trouble with the A bomb side. NK's gonna get taken down meanwhile by Ass Buster over near checkers. And that's a huge blow to accuracy, because that's going to split the defense even more. Now just two guys over in A, two guys in B, no one marking mid. I have no information. And Jing, fortunately for the CTs, the Jing Bang is not going to be peeking into mid. As spawn with the AWP is going to catch up Ass Buster. Over in Forklift. Fork on over in NVK. And no, they have one guy over in mid now, as spawn, shifting his position up. And they're going to be facing some action very, very soon. Smoke's raining in. And the C4 is going to come in. There's a guy over in mid as well, and spawn. He's going back to B, and this could be disastrous because they have a man flanking in from highway as well. But Falcon over in NBK, he could be a very crucial man indeed. The UAV is going to get spotted by the guy over in highway. He's going to get taken down by Smoker. And Falcon still playing it very safely. Though, and Nato running and gunning through the smoke like a wraith, comes in, takes his head off, and they're going to be able to get the bomb done. It's all down to spawn and Pyro to salvage this round. Going to be comfortable here. Smoker holding a very close angle over from highway. It's going to take down spawn. Spawn not expecting Smoker to be holding so close. And it's going to all leave it under Pyro. And what's Pyro doing? He should get away from here as fast as possible before the T's gather together and come in. He's going to spot the first man. Takes out Smoker. And right now, Jingman can go for this hunt. They have so much money to play with. They don't need to play safe here. But Jingman not leaving anything to chance. As they're going to clear the bomb side out, and they have the man coming in from near CD spawn to hunt down Pyro. Pyro going to be going mid, making a lot of noise. Should be able to hold on his rifle. There we go. And it's going to be round number 14 for Jing Bang, as they're looking pretty solid. And accuracy gaming, they're not able to go for his early trades. It's Jing Bang usually getting the opening kills, and this A side has just been looking so suspect. They're not really contesting mains control or even pushing into noisy, because that's something they should have tried a long time back when they realized this passive hold in the A-bombs that's not working out, aggressing a little bit and shutting it down. You know, even if you get the first, even if you die, your first guy dies, you should have another guy to trade for him, you know? Cat, I think it was Pasha, I think, who's been playing from Squeaky. There we go, again. He's over in Squeaky. And they know he's doing this almost every single time. So what they could have done is Falcon and Leo could have pushed into Squeaky at least a couple of rounds and kind of caught him off guard. Just hold the angle, you know? Catch him off guard, take him down. And even if one of you guys die, you know, get the trade at least. And from then, you know, you can work on that. You can work the round from there. Or maybe push into mains. Get some control. But the fact is, Aggressive Gaming is so playing so passively that the second they lose one member, they have absolutely no map control remaining. And then it becomes very, very hard indeed for them to come back from that. And this is very, very weak indeed. And Jing Bang, they know that they are ensuring that they have, you know, complete map control. Meanwhile, spawn is pushing into mid, and he hears the T's running into B, so that's gonna draw the rotation. But here's a smart thing: they have Pasha as well over in the A bomb site, and be careful here. He could catch him all off guard. This could be absolutely huge. Spots one, takes his time. He's gonna get the kill though. Should be careful. The two guys waiting for him. He doesn't have to peek out. Doesn't have to go for the fight. He's gonna get taken down. But Pyro's gonna find Smoker. NK in the bomb site. A 4v3 man advantage for the CTs. And with 20 seconds remaining on the clock, they got to make a call here. They got to make the play here to tease. 15 seconds remaining now. And Pyro spraying through the smoke. He's not gonna find anyone though. And they have a guy flanking in from CD spawn. But Forkin is waiting for Pasha. He's gonna take him down. Aspos is gonna find another man here. 7 seconds on the clock. They got to make a play now. And it's the last man left alive. And it's gonna be blood filler with the C4. He's gonna opt to just get the hell out of there. No time remaining whatsoever. And it's gonna be accuracy winning that round, and that too primarily because Spawn pushing so deep over in mid. He heard them rotating, he went for the flank, he just got the one kill, but he conveyed information to his teammates who were able to rotate much more earlier than would have happened if Spawn hadn't pushed so deep. So that's what I'm talking about. Getting some map control gives you so much crucial information that you're able to rotate teammates over to one side, you know, stack it and read the terrorists. But right now, because accuracy have been playing so passively, they haven't been able to get this information. Spawn trying it again to go mid aggressively. He's pushing pretty deep as well. This is a risky play from him, but it just might work out for him here. Smoke is still there, hasn't dissipated quite yet. Be able to catch out Bloodfiller if he's smart enough here. And once again, like I said, the same setup is not very great here, and it's gonna be Pasha peeking out from top. He's gonna find Spawn as NK is gonna take him down. And that's gonna actually, that's interesting. Now we have some aggression coming out from the CTs. No, actually, the T's are going to fall back. They're going to fall back to A bombs. I really thought they're going to go rotate over to B. But now it's a 3v5. And here's the thing, right? Leo and Falcon, they've been playing from Forklift and from NBK pretty much throughout all the time. And it's been working out for them. Why can't they shift it up? Why can't they, you know, set up a crossfire, you know, a double stack over in mains perhaps? Falcon's going to find one of the kill here, but Smoker's going to take him down, leaving it now to a 2v2. From a 4v3, Pyro coming in. But the retake is waiting for his teammate, who is NK over in CD spawn, to come in as well over from truck. And Pyro's made his way here pretty comfortably, and I don't think the T's have spotted him out yet. Flash. NK spots both of them out here. He should get the kill. Nope, Aspas is going to take him down, and Pyro is going to find one, but Smoker's there for the immediate trade, and that's going to be Jing Bang on map point and accuracy. Their A site is abysmal. The A side hole is just abysmal, and Jing Bang, they know it, and they are punishing them over and over and over and over and over again. And I'm just so surprised that Accuracy Gaming haven't shifted it up. And they're just hoping and praying that this two-man hold over an A side is going to work out for them. It is not. You need some variation in your setup. You need to push in either through Squeaky or mains or even a triple stack, something different. And this hole where they have one guy in NBK, one guy in Forklift, it's just not working out for them, and they still keep trying the same thing. So, need some variation on CD side for Accuracy Gaming. And Jing Bang is just exploiting this. They're just exploiting this ruthlessly. That's Buster. Meanwhile, again, over for his B lurk. It's going to be a very desperate buy coming out from Accuracy Gaming. They have the 1M4 NK. They have 4 5-7s with armor. And just a few flashbangs. That's all they have in the kitty. That's Jing Bang. We'll be looking to close this out once again, setting up for this A play. They once again have Pasha behind Squeaky. We have Nato and Bloodfiller setting up for the smokes now, and Smoker slowly peeking in. Once again, Pasha's designated spot. He's going to push out, but Liu Adrian gets a very, very lucky kill on the Pasha there. But now Smoker, Aspas is going to find a man, and the C4 is going to make its way all the way over to B here. Aspas opening things up in the B bombsite, but he has to still contend with the guy that is Pyro inside the bombsite with the 5-7, and he's going to get a great kill on the Aspas. They're still going to fork in behind the smoke. He can't push in yet, but the T's are just going to push in. Bloodfiller is going to catch a Pyro, and oh, a little lucky there, as Nato is going to save his teammate, and it's all on Leo Adrian and Spawn to make something happen of what looks like a pretty much a gone round here, a lost cause here, a lost round, as Smoker is going to find Leo Adrian, and last man left alive is going to be Spawn in a 1v3. I've seen him pull off some crazy stuff in the past, but this should be almost impossible for the man. 9 points of well, that's all he has, and Smoker just toying with him, and finally he's going to take him down. 16-9, GG, well played being called out, and there you have it. As Jing Jang, win that game with a bang. 16-9, it looked pretty one-sided indeed. Their T-side was something that Accuracy Gaming really couldn't do much here. Accuracy Gaming, it was 8-7. It was 8-7, where they had 7 rounds on the CTs on their T-side, and they just got 2 rounds on the CT side. That just goes to show Jing Bang's T-side were just phenomenal. Accuracy CD side, their A-side especially, was just abysmal. Just very unimaginative. They could have tried some different setups or whatnot, but I guess that also comes with the fact that also comes to play the fact that Spawn is a stand-in, and maybe that's why, I'm not sure. Did expect better from Accuracy, but taking nothing away from Jing Bang, they played spectacularly, and they have been looking really on point. You guys play more deeper in the tournament, but that's it from our end here, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you guys again tomorrow, which should be at least a couple of games. It is, of course, Saturday, and I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow. It should be 8 to 10 for the CSGO action. And yeah, guys, enjoy the stream and the cast. And I will be seeing you guys tomorrow. Thank you for watching. It is, of course, week 2 of the ESL India Premiership, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with some more crazy and hopefully more intense and good Counter-Strike action.